that. You learn that?
Generally.
Right.
I suppose I'm a bit more sanctioned.
And welcome to, we've got two members of the committee, which are well-known councillors. I've not been on before. Brian Kenny.
Can I
come in? No, Anthony's really welcome. Tommy's been on before, John's been on before, and I've been on 16. And Eddie's been on before, and yes, you guys have been. Okay, I've got two apologies. That's George Davis, Chris Bean, and that's Mike Sullivan, Gary Watts. David Joyce,
yeah.
Okay, then. Anybody want to address? No? Minutes of last week, any matters arising?
Three.
Okay.
Three.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Item four, item five.
National Health Service Trust. They wanted to show the film
as part of this promotion at this particular month. So on the 13th of May, members of the Licensing Act Subcommittee viewed the film, which is called Tigers. And members had reference to the British Board of Film Classification Guidance and resolved to classify the film with the PG classification. As I say, you can see within the report that previous films have been classified in this way by members. And as I say, it was really for information so that members are aware of what is happening. As I say, the main concern, the main priority of members when considering such responsibility is the protection of children from harm, which is one of the licensing objectives. And that's the reason why it falls to the Licensing Act Committee.
Okay. Thank you. Any questions? Move the recommendation, Chair. Okay. All right?
Great.
Great. Okay. Right. Say a few words of the train because just to alert members, I think that's been speaking to Mark last week. I think there's a few things going to come up in the next 12 months on medicine. 2003, and maybe legislation coming up about the taxis. So, with all that in mind, we may have to deal with the business a bit earlier, but I'll hand it over back to Mark now.
Okay, thank you, Chair. Yeah, there's two main things with regard to training. The first an important thing is obviously for new members. I need to organise some specific training for yourself. That can be done in two ways, and I did send out an email regarding formal training that's taking place in either York or Preston. They were the nearest locations. That's delivered by barristers who work with Institute of Licensing, and other members, I think, can say who've been on that training have found it very useful. So that is this formal training. What I need to do as well is to provide, and I can do it in a number of ways, can either do one-to-one training or I can bring you all together as a group for new members for when you are available. Because you wouldn't be able to sit on any hearing of a license application until you have received that training. So we need to organise that, and I can speak to you outside of the meeting regarding dates and times that we can actually do that. Obviously that can be open to any members as well for refresher training if anybody else wanted to attend that once we've set out how we're going to do that. The other thing is, as Councillor Davis indicated, there have been changes to the Licensing Act legislation itself, and I would like to provide an update to all members in respect of those changes which specifically affect entertainment under the legislation. So if you can give me an indication, if possible, tonight as to when you want that training, whether it's during the day, whether it's during the evening, and possible dates that we could look at to do that. Also raised by Councillor Niblock was reference in the guidance to other legislation outside of the Licensing Act that can impact on the work that you do. And that primarily falls under environmental health remit, and I've spoken with the manager, Colin Clayton, and he's quite prepared to do the training jointly with me. So we can say that would be part of the update on the new legislation and reference to other pieces of legislation that affect what is happening. So I'd like to move forward as quickly as possible on that so that you are up to date, not only as members of the Licensing Act Committee, but also for local residents that you might get questions about that you would have dealt with differently 6 months ago to how we deal with them now. That's okay.
Thank you, madam.
I would anticipate an hour. It always depends on how many questions people have or anything, but you know, in terms of the changes themselves, I could probably run through say 20 minutes of mine, and then Colin would give an overview on primarily sources like noise pollution legislation and public safety, some public safety legislation there.
Would members around 5 o'clock then? Right hand. That suits. I'm going to put an email tomorrow to confirm. Okay.
Half five should be. I'll get the ferry over then soon.
Half five, yeah. Okay. Can we?
I don't want half five.
Okay. So if that's really helpful, if I could know any dates that were definitely not suitable or any days that are not suitable.
I'm sure he says.
Can I suggest that you put an email out tomorrow morning?
Yeah.
And people respond and put a couple of dates, okay.
Yeah. And would it be easier if I compose a date or because we back at we'd have to probably go around several times with different emails before say if you know now, like say for example if you said don't do it on Monday, I mean I won't make it on Friday.
Yes.
Tuesday to Wednesday, as in Tuesday, probably on the Wednesday.
17th. Sorry, I suggest that you do a long term certain dates on it, what's the tip of dates that you make?
Yeah, and I can do more than once.
Yeah. I mean, you can do some dates, so everyone can choose what day, and most people are free for that.
Bear in mind, council is the 6th and 13th, which is all that I'm on these.
Okay.
Remember that this committee is different from the rest. You can't get a deputy for this committee. So if you agree to do a hearing and all of a sudden someone comes up, you can't. You'd have to be reserving the officers. So it's unlike like planning or like the next meeting GP. Say you've got someone gone all day, oh I can't come to me, I'll get to bring somebody else. This committee is totally different. Once the three's picked, yeah, we're all nice. And once the three's been picked, then you have a reserve as well. But you can't get a deficit because there's 15 in the pool. And that's important to remember that.
And unless the deputy is a member of that pool.
Member of that pool, that's okay. Yeah, that's okay. But what I'll do for everybody, we'll put all the names of the people that's on the pool so everyone knows. Right, I don't think it will do. Yeah, it's one of them. Okay? And you've got no more markers?
Yeah. I mean, I think what normally happens on that is if somebody does get to a point where they can't make it, they just let them know. It's rather than you work it out amongst yourselves. That's why it's not
happening. Okay. I probably just the business. That concludes the business for this committee tonight. And we've got the 6 o'clock committee in general purposes.